National grasslands, I would argue, are the biggest ecological restoration success story in the history of humankind.
That's how Dan Svegan, District Ranger and Capital City Coordinator for the U.S. Forest Service, feels about the National Grassland, a program born out of the Dust Bowl and Depression era of the 1930s.
In response to that hardship, the federal government launched the land utilization projects where they bought back some of the sub-marginal land, and then they went about trying to restore that and trying to get it with grass again so that the Dust Bowl would abate, so that the dust would stop blowing.
The Soil Conservation Service, today's NRCS, was launched, and large tracts of land were set aside in 13 states. In South Dakota, they include Buffalo Gap, Grand River, and the Fort Pierre National Grassland. And from the beginning, the goal has been mixed use of the restored prairie.
So the three big ones locally are conservation, livestock grazing, and recreation. Conservation, we support one of the healthiest greater prairie chicken populations left. We're also real important for a lot of these grassland birds that are disappearing range-wide. In terms of livestock grazing, our neighbors pasture their privately owned cattle under permit on the national grassland. And that's just a godsend. That is our primary management tool to manipulate the health of the grass. And then for recreation, we get lots of visitors coming in for hunting. We get lots of visitors coming in for bird watching, camping, and fishing.
So the National Grassland encourages you to turn off the highway and enjoy what the land has to offer. But if you already live there and raise livestock, it's not only your family business, but you're also a key part of the prairie ecosystem.
I reminisce back when Save Lewis and Clark was around here and it had all the buffalo roaming around. You had a 3-inch rain and the buffalo were moving through here in the millions, and the ground would look like a plowed up sod field. Well, that was restoring the grass seeds back into the ground and utilizing, getting that stimulating, breaking up the dead grasses and putting in the seed. The livestock now are in the process of replacing the buffalo in that deal. So their hooving action breaks up the thatch and replants the native seeds back in the ground and brings back the native plants.
Noel Henriksen was not only born here, he has a grassland grazing permit for his livestock, and he represents his fellow ranchers on the board of the local grazing district, which is a group that works with the Forest Service to maintain the land and find agreement when changes are needed.
Well, I think the pasture rotation system has changed a lot through the years. We used to be season long in some of the pastures, and now we're doing a 3 or 4 pasture rotation to give the grasses a rest.
Granted, the groups don't always see eye to eye, but they are working together, along with researchers at many area universities, to study any new threats that come to the grassland.
A real big project that we're just getting started on is these invasive species. So we're dominated by this mixed grass prairie, but the exotic grasses, especially smooth brome and Kentucky bluegrass, are a huge threat.
That issue is one that all the groups agree needs to be addressed, but it's more than work. They have a real passion for this land.
I've been lucky to work throughout the American West and work in several biomes. And when we moved back to the Dakotas, when we crossed the state line, I could just feel myself relax. A visceral feeling that this is home.
It gets to you, it's just part of your soul. So it's a wonderful place to be.